And joining us on Hot Copy this morning, we have Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual. Secretary Pascual, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, what an honor to have you on Head Start. Thank you for joining us, sir. It's the first time you are on the show. I'd like to ask you first, sir, is the country prepared for RCEP?
We are prepared for RCEP in the sense that there are things that have to be done, and we are ready to do such things. We're saying RCEP is not a magic pill or magic medicine that will at once lift up our economy. The stakeholders have to do their part. You know, the businesses, the MSMEs, the regulatory agencies, the departments that are in charge in supporting enterprises in strengthening their capabilities.
Okay, so Secretary, you said that different sectors have to do their part, strengthen their capabilities, but upon the initial implementation of RCEP, I wanted to ask you, there are certain fears already at this point. Number one, because of the lower tariff revenues of RCEP, the Philippines stands to lose roughly $58 million in revenues alone due to the concessions under RCEP. Is this correct, sir?
Are you saying tariff revenues?
Yes.
I don't have the exact figure, but I wonder where that number came from.
Mm-mm. Okay. So clearly, have you at least, do you know the possible losses that the Philippines will incur, at least in the first year, perhaps?
Why are we looking at losses and not potential gains? I think we have to change the perspective. We have to lead our stakeholders, our businesses, so that they are able to take advantage of the provisions of the RCEP. We are talking as if, you know, we are at the full receiving end of RCEP. We are not, you know. There are gains that can be achieved by even by some agricultural products. There are products that are now maybe exported to China, Japan, or Korea at lower tariff than before. So these are potential gains.
Yeah. I think the reason why these groups have come out and voiced out their fears is because the Philippines is primarily an importing country more than an exporting country. So moving with this discussion, the Asian Development Bank, for example, came out with a report that actually said the countries that stand to benefit most from RCEP is China, Japan, and South Korea. But the Philippines will only stand to gain $2 billion by 2030 pa po ito. So ang tanong dito, clearly there are gains, but have we measured it in terms of the scope?
There were studies made by well-known economists. One that says, if we don't join, we lose 0.6 percentage points of our GDP, and if we join, we gain 2% percentage points.
Okay, go on, sir.
There will be commodities that will make it cheaper for our manufacturers to produce products that can be exported, for example, to Japan. Take garments.
Yeah.
Currently, since we do not have the textile, if we just do the sewing in the Philippines, we cannot avail of the tariff concession from Japan, given that there is a requirement for local content in the rules of origin. Now, under RCEP, the rules of origin have been broadened so that we can buy the textile from China, do the sewing here, and export to Japan. The textile bought from China will be counted into the determination of the local content to be able to meet the rules of origin.
Okay. Now, what other...
So importation, take note that half of what we import are raw materials and intermediate products,
Mm-mm.
which eventually a big part of that goes into exportable products.
Mm-mm. Okay. Yes, and I'm actually reading right now some of the benefits from RCEP. This is based on the documents that were released. You were noting that there will be a wider sourcing of raw materials, which will help Philippine manufacturers. And one of the benefits listed is allowing Filipino professionals to practice their profession in RCEP areas. Can you expound on this, Secretary? What does that exactly mean?
Well, what it means is that under RCEP, there is a provision that opens up the member countries to professionals mm-hmm. coming from another country.
Mm.
Actually, professionals are just part of what we call services, which can mm-hmm. include education, consulting, other types mm. of service enterprises
mm.
that will now be available from Philippine enterprises or Philippine groups and can be exercised or practiced in other member countries of RCEP.
Yes, okay. How do we then protect the agricultural sector? There are fears by some groups that because of RCEP, it will widen the agri-sector's trade deficit. Do you agree with this, sir?
Yes, we are conscious of that. That's mm-hmm. why our negotiators were very strong in their position to list down certain products that will be excluded from the tariff adjustments.
Okay.
For example, rice, cereal, meal pellets, rolled flake grains, sugar, instant coffee, feed for animals,
Mm-mm.
poultry meat, swine meat, lettuce, Mm-mm. carrots, cabbages, onions, etc. So there are these products whose tariff protection will remain and
yes.
will not be adjusted under RCEP.
Uh-oh. But to be fair, there are also agri products that under RCEP will face tariff elimination to 15 years, 1 to 15 years. Tama ito, Secretary.
Yeah, it's correct.
Uh-oh.
But take note, what are these products? Many of these products we don't produce.
Yeah, like spinach.
Like sausages.
I know we do produce spinach.
We do produce some sausages, but
yeah.
olives.
Okay.
Olive oil.
Mm-mm.
Live swine, live chicken. We don't export live swine or live chicken.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
So these products are not, most of them are not available from the Philippines.
Yeah.
For export. Uh-oh.
And let's look at the other side of the coin. How does this benefit our agricultural sector? With RCEP, for example, the Philippines is known for mangoes, bananas, pineapples.
Yeah.
Does this benefit our agri-industry in any way?
Yes, surely. Preferential tariff commitments from China, Japan, and Korea, better than what's available from ASEAN-China FTA, ASEAN-Japan CEP, and ASEAN-Korea FTA. This include Philippine export of interests, such as preserved pineapple, will be now given preferential tariff by China. For example, papaya, durian, soybean will be given preferential tariff by Korea, including women's jacket, men's shirt, bicycles, which we produce.
So the key
there
really
will be benefits.
Yeah.
And the ones where that we want to protect will remain protected with the existing tariff.
Mm.